Let me tell you a little bit about what Rust is about.
Rust is a secret weapon.
Rust is a community project.
Rust has learned from the mistakes of the past.
Rust is a systems programming language that is safe, concurrent, and fast.
I've got one word for you. Rust.
Traditionally, we think about systems programming in terms of things like power tools. So C++ is something like a chainsaw. So it's very powerful. You can definitely get your work done. It can hack through anything. But it's also really easy to, you know, chop your foot off, as they say. One of the things we like to say about Rust is that it's a safe systems language.
Which means that there is checking at compile time that eliminates large classes of programming errors, and specifically the kinds of programming errors that are most likely to lead to security vulnerabilities.
There's a well-known connection between safety and security that when you work with unsafe technologies, you're always one programming mistake away from a potentially disastrous security flaw in your software.
In 1988, we found the first internet virus. The Morris worm had a bunch of different ways to break into machines on the internet, but one of them was caused by an error in the way a particular network service used memory. So basically, there's this minor error, right? Oh, that's too much data. Didn't think of that. Turns out that that's enough to give anybody on the net control of your computer. Now, through 2016, that particular kind of attack has continued to be a primary vector for bad guys trying to break into machines. It happens today.
And so many parts of the internet are built on software that we all need to trust. As society depends on the internet more and more, the costs of security holes get bigger and bigger. What Rust offers is some core development tools that we can use to build a more secure internet.
So under the hood, Rust is preventing entire classes of safety and security bugs that you'll see in C and C++.
The compiler will catch certain categories of errors that other languages ask the developer, oh, please just be very clever and always notice these.
All of these bugs related to memory corruption or out-of-bounds indexing or use after freeze or double freeze, all of these bugs are just completely erased in Rust.
The Rust compiler is able to check immediately when you write the program whether you have made any of these mistakes or not. And so you have a huge degree of confidence when you compile the program before you even submit it or show your patch to anyone, or certainly before you ship it to users, that you haven't made these kinds of errors. And that is very empowering in a way that C++ is not.
The end game is that infrastructure and systems code and embedded code is written in a language that empowers me to make changes with confidence, to hack without fear.
Hack without fear means a lot of things. It means that if you've been afraid of being a systems programmer, you don't have to be afraid anymore. It means that if you're shipping your code in production, you don't have to be afraid of certain painful bugs. It means that you can start using Rust in production without being afraid of having to be an expert.
You can get involved in systems programming language without necessarily learning everything ahead of time. I think that's basically a game changer for systems programming.
Come to Rust and you feel like you suddenly have superpowers.
I love Rust.
Congratulations on starting Rust.
Go try Rust.